Okay, so I am now recording with one camera, and I'm about to hit the live stream on the next. I'll use a lower resolution. I have the wrong title up on this video, so I'm going to have to try and change it while I'm live. I'm going to reset the title. It's no longer about the Bearcat. This is about Garret Ean and his situation with the Sheriff's Department of Keene. Sees Sheriff, I'll just call it that. And say done. Okay, so we are broadcasting, we are live. Garret Ean, we're here in Keene on our way to the Sheriff's Department. You've just received a notice in the mail that looks like this, and I'll try and get a video of that. Here's the piece of paper. Okay. We are driving and I'm operating two cameras, so I apologize for this very shaky view. But here's what it looks like. So Garret, what's going on?
Well, this morning, one of my roommates said, "Hey Garret, this was left for you." And it was, I believe, in the door, like in the doorknob of the front door of the place where I stay. And it's from the Cheshire County Sheriff's Office. We see this decorative font, and it's to Ean Garret, which isn't my name, and it's spelled wrong, even if it was flipped and made.
Why is that? Sense. Well, how's it spelled wrong?
Ean is my last name, Garret is my first name.
And it has...
And my name has one T in it, not two, so... It's totally incorrect, but that's not the first time the state has addressed me in this manner. I've almost come to expect it.
Okay.
So, they have something for me, presumably a document. We won't really know until we find out. You know, they're not exactly known for being information liberators in law enforcement. Usually they're information, they search for information and they hold on to it.
Did you request some videographers come with you?
Well, my friends were interested, and we are in Keene, New Hampshire, and it would be common that if you're going to have an interaction with law enforcement, you want to be videotaping that. So, yeah, it's glad that a few people have stepped up already and been like, let's go see what's going on.
Why do you say that? Why would you want to record an interaction with law enforcement?
Anytime you have an interaction with law enforcement, you're having an interaction with someone who is acting as the state's agent and wanting to enforce the laws of the state, laws that ostensibly not all of us agreed to, not all of us consent to. So I find it important to document whenever any of that sort of thing is going on. It gives the individual who is documenting the upper hand to be able to prove that it's not just one's word against another. And also the idea of if I have an interaction with someone in an official capacity, I feel it's more responsible to be able to record that, make a record of it, that can be objective, that anyone can see and anyone can point to. As opposed to the fragility of our own memories and our own ability to recall incidents. So videography is a wonderful, empowering tool that we have, and I'm glad that so many people here in this community are taking it upon themselves to use those tools. And that person kind of just jumped down the road.
Who specifically do you expect to be speaking to?
Probably the person behind the front desk, or however the setup is at the Cheshire County Sheriff's Department. I would expect that they probably just have a paper to give me. There's always, of course, scenarios in which, you know, people could be lured into a place for an arrest. I don't presume that's the case with me. However, it's not to say it's never happened before to activists where they've just been asked to, you know, receive some paperwork, receive a document, pick someone up from jail, and they get arrested. So, yeah, I don't know what it's in reference to. It could be a civil... some sort of civil matter, or it could be a subpoena, because subpoenas are supposed to be given in hand if they want me to be witness to something. I know that our friend Rich Paul is facing charges of having, I forget the way the charge is worded, but pretty much brandished a sort of weapon. There's a monopod that he had that they were saying he was brandishing as though it was a baton. And, yeah, so...
So what would the subpoena be in relation to your video?
I'm thinking that if some sort of hearing or some sort of deposition on that matter was scheduled, that maybe I would be subpoenaed for that.
Is this the direction
from the defense or from the prosecution?
Is this the direction of the courthouse that we're heading right now?
No, right now we're heading towards the direction of the CAC, which is kind of in the direction of the courthouse.
Why?
So we could put out a blast for more people that wish to be there.
Oh, okay. I was expecting to live stream on our way there. I thought that we were going there right now.
Yeah, we can go there right now. We don't really have to stop. This is Red Lobster. I'm inbound to the courthouse from near Leverett.
This is Red Lobster. I'm inbound to the courthouse from near Leverett.
What do you... So tell us what you just did.
Well, I just put out a blast on the radio informing people that I'm headed down there that we're interested.
Heading over.
And
heading over.
Yeah, so there we go. There's one response. Somebody that's interested in heading down. I believe that's Ian Freeman.
Are you concerned at all that you just gave away your code name?
Not really. I'm sure there's plenty of video on Freeman TV Raw of myself being identified by my radio moniker.
What's the worst that could happen?
Worst case scenario is there's some sort of arrest. I suppose. I mean, really worst case scenario is like Obama's here to send us all to Guantanamo, and this is like some lore, and they take us into the basement of the sheriff's department, fly us on a CIA rendition plane somewhere. But I don't expect that. I like to think Obama's a nicer guy than that, or whoever it would be, Janet Napolitano, whoever's involved in this. I guess we can park here and just walk. It's kind of around the corner.
Okay.
Oh, no, wait, this is reserved. I guess we can't park here.
There's a shot of the courthouse. It's coming up. Thank you. So, I'll take over the video from here. I've got a tripod that I'm setting up now. Okay. Live stream. This is special for me because I was banned from the Superior Court, and I was told that I needed to get special permission from the sheriff if I ever wanted to go to the courthouse. That was ruled unconstitutional, but not because of me. I didn't challenge that. I pled guilty, said okay, I trespassed on the courthouse against without asking permission, but I'm curious if there will be any incident today. So for that reason, I'm going to stand back. I'm going to be the safety shot so that if anything happens, we'll capture that from a safe distance and be able to upload the video for that.
What are they doing? It's always good whenever you're going into the clutches of the state to ensure that there's nothing in your pockets they wouldn't like. Before you go through TSA. I don't believe there's any sort of security at this gate that we're going to, but...
Can you speak up? I don't think we heard you.
It's fine. I don't believe there's any sort of security where we're going, but whenever I go into a state institution, I always do a precursory check of my pockets, see what I have on me.
This kid has got more hair
myself
than he's got body.
And some others are around the corner on Short Street on our way down.
Around
the corner of Court Street on our way down through winter. I don't expect you'd need much time. 30 minutes.
How'd you get so much hair?
3 years of growth.
3 years of growth?
Yeah.
You don't have a black mother or black father.
I don't think so. I have some Italian heritage.
Okay, the conversation right now is just centering around Garrett's hair, so I'm going to face the camera this way until something interesting happens. All right, great.
All right, so we're headed down to the... Oh, I should probably bring that piece of paper. I didn't grab
it. Okay, Garrett is retrieving the piece of paper that ordered him to come here.
So I got the piece of paper with me. I got my two-way with me. I've got this Nikon. I've got this camera. I can get stills with this, I can get video with this. And I'm gonna start running my primary video. What's going on? Good morning. So we've got other videographers behind us. This is a very, this is what good coverage is.
Yeah, talk about good coverage. I see a camera behind me. Camera behind there.
Are you guys filming? We're heading into the sheriff's office to pick up some papers.
So yeah, what happened here?
So this morning, one of my roommates informed me that this was left on the front of the house. It says it's for Ian Garrett. Report to the sheriff's office for a document entry and service required. Doesn't say what it's in reference to or what it might be. So it could be a number of things. It could be a subpoena. It could be some sort of civil proceeding or some sort of ruling.
Okay, and at this point, I will say that I am the safety guy. I am broadcasting live. Very good. Okay. Ian, Garrett, and Manic are headed inside now, all with video cameras. Now, as far as I know, cameras are not welcome inside that building, but that was when that was considered a courthouse. So now cameras should be fine. It is only the place of the sheriff's office, so it'll be unclear to see what happens to the people inside there. I'm gonna keep these cameras rolling, focused on the courthouse, and without narration, because I don't think anything specifically interesting is bound to happen. You just see some workers here in the background. They're doing some landscaping work around the area of the courthouse. Is brief. Very difficult for me to get a closer shot given the construction work that's being done. Typically I would be able to go right up to the door, but as you can see, there is really no sidewalk that leads up to the door. just to recap for folks who are now joining us live, Garret Ean was given notice by the sheriff's office via mail today that he is to appear. He is complying with that order at the moment by going in to visit the sheriff's department. He said he expects to just speak with whoever's at the window, find out what sort of business they want with him, and he'll be on his way. The worst that could happen is that he's arrested. I suppose the best that happens is they say, we have some more paperwork for you, or perhaps they're going to subpoena him for a trial. See someone exiting the courthouse, but it is not someone of interest, just a regular person struggling to leave a place that has really no options. She looks very disappointed with this landscaping. Now, by this point, I would have expected that Garret has spoken with the people on the inside. The sheriff's department is, as I remember it, just downstairs from the entryway doors, so it would have been easy enough for him to get to the front window, and he's probably in conversation with the folks there now. Again, I'm just the safety shot, so what you're seeing right now is the outside of the courthouse, in case there's any incident that happens inside. I'm supposed to be the video that survives if none others do. And here's Ean first out the door, and Garret Ean behind him, and then Manic. So it appears all are safe. This is very good news. I'm gonna get up and ask for an interview. So, Garret, what happened?
Is this a good spot here in the shade?
Yeah.
All right, so I went in there, downstairs to the office. There was a woman behind the desk who assisted me. And I said, I received this morning.
Real loud.
Be loud?
Yeah.
Okay. I said, I received this morning on the porch of the place I inhabit. And she asked if I was Garret. And I said, I'm Garret, but I'm not Ean Garret, the name that's on there. And she said, are you Garret Ean? And I said, yes. So she went to retrieve something, a small piece of paper that was in an envelope. And it's a subpoena, as I was thinking that maybe one of the things this was. It's a subpoena to appear on a violation of probation hearing for Richard Paul on July 10th, which is tomorrow, at 1:15 p.m. 33 Winter Street, right next door is the courthouse we'll be going to. And I'll be testifying about the incident that landed him, that basically is one of the reasons they revoked his probation and have locked him up at the Cheshire County House of Corrections. He's been there, I believe, 4, maybe 5 weeks now, related to an incident that occurred in Central Square. They also cited his having not completed a drug rehabilitation that they wanted him to go through, and he's posted a blog recently about how he doesn't consider his cannabis use an addiction. It's something that he does for his own personal benefit and medical benefit, and that it's not something he's going to be having to take out of his life. And so I think it's there's that issue, as well as a supposed weapons violation related to an incident in Central Square where there were multiple people who were being physically threatened, who were making threats. One person was attacked physically by two different people. And Rich Paul is alleged to have been holding or brandishing a weapon, which they right. were calling a baton, which I believe was a monopod that he was using. He put down his camera and the other item to use it in a defensive manner. And this goes to the heart of whether or not people who are on probation or are felons have the right to defend themselves against violence using just an ordinary but sort of device that's lying around.
Back to you, though. I mean, what would be the penalty if you didn't show up here today?
Hereof fail not, as you will answer your default under penalties prescribed by law. That's very ominous. It's the last sentence of this message. It says you are required to appear before the Cheshire County Superior Court. So, hereof fail not. They're writing this stuff in Old English. I don't know why they just say plainly. You may be incarcerated for failure to appear. I think that's unlikely. What will probably happen is it'll just be negative for Rich not having my testimony as to what happened.
Can you give us a shot of the paper, or is there personal info on that?
I'm not really concerned about my address being out, so...
Thank you.
So yeah, so tomorrow will be the day. I'll spend some time tonight going over the facts of the case. I've begun to prepare a report that I haven't released yet related to that incident and the incident the next day as far as what can be determined from the video evidence that we have from those two incidents of violence that occurred in Central Square. It's unfortunately the only person that's been punished relative to violence that's occurred is someone who did not engage in violence. Someone only engaged in he's not accused of touching anyone, of physically threatening anyone, just holding something in a defensive manner to protect themselves. Even if you look at the video, you see Rich is backing away.
Yeah, but back to what's happening right now, were you threatened with anything with using a video camera inside in the courthouse?
No, this isn't a courthouse anymore.
Okay, so this is just the sheriff's office.
Yeah, it's nice actually when we went in, we used to have that big metal detector you'd have to walk under, and it was kind of caged, chained off at least, not really caged off. And where the court office used to be, now there's these metal grates over it, almost like it's a store in the mall that's been closed. And really it's just moved next door, but it's funny to see that in this building that has this very Soviet feel to it. It's this big old brick building, and inside it's pretty dark, and the ceilings are high. It has a strange feel about it.
What's the name of the person with whom you spoke?
I didn't even get her name, it was just the woman behind the counter.
Did she sign your paper?
It's signed, it says like deputy something.
May I get a shot of that?
Deputy is the blue writing is what she signed.
Thank you. All right, I'm gonna end it there. I wanna thank everyone who traveled out here with me. Getting all of the redundant video sometimes can be a waste, but other times, it's the only video you've got after the police steal it. So we're gonna head back to the car now, and I've got a show that I'm doing. Check out Bitcoin Talk Show at bitcointalkshow.com. We're about to go live in minutes. Peace.